And Greg Charvat,
that's right.
I get that right, is a author of Small and Short Range Radar Systems. I've read it three or four times. I love it.
Thank you very much.
First of all, but before we get into that, radar for dummies, real okay. quick.
It's real quick. So your viewers can do this at home. You get a flashlight, get a swivel chair like this, turn off the lights, put the flashlight in your head and spin around. What the flashlight bounces off of is what the radar sees. That's life through the eyes of a radar.
Okay, and our perception of radar in the modern age mm-hmm. is that it's sophisticated enough, it's on the border of all these countries, mm-hmm. that it can see a pigeon flying into their airspace. That's probably an exaggeration.
That would be. Assuming the pigeon's close enough, maybe you can see one.
But what about a 777? Could it fly over China into Kazakhstan without being noticed? How would it have to happen?
It's anything like this is possible, but to do it, you'd have to have very detailed information of the type of radars, their disposition, their heights, and their waveforms to actually pull that off. You'd have to know a lot.
So it would be like flying a video game. The pilot would have yep. to know the certain altitude and path he'd have to go.
Yeah.
Okay.
You'd have to know a lot.
When the Indian government says, you know, we're more focused on the Pakistan border yep. for obvious reasons. Yep. We don't pay as much attention to the Bay of Bengal down there. Mm-hmm. Does that surprise you?
I can't speak to their geopolitical situation. You know, it wouldn't surprise me one bit. Depends how much money they want to spend on it, you know?